Okay, people, this is Millsarab Dude here. And I just thought this would be a pretty good video for people to see. So this right here is a Mosin-Nagant rifle book by Terrence W. Lappin. I'm sure I'm butchering the name. It's the 5th edition revised from North Cape Publications. And this is a great book if you collect Mosin-Nagants. This is the book to have. Finish Mosin-Nagants, you know, all different branches. Right now I only have a 9130, but I'm looking to expand. So, had this book for a while. I read it from front to back completely. It has a lot of good things that it's really a pain to find online, such as this is the finished Civil Guard rifle numbers, a lot like this, and then they have an entire section just markings, and this is production for 1944 for the Mosin-Nagant carbine, and notice they don't have 1943 because 1943 is a very insignificant date. This is because those were only pre-production years for the 44, I mean the M44 at Mosin-Nagant. The 1943 year is just it's only like the prototype, and I believe only 50,000 were made. If you want to see a video, you should go see about the 1943. You should go see check out Marshall Zhukov's YouTube channel. He has a pretty good video. It's actually one of his first videos showing his 1943 M44 Mosin-Nagant carbine. So this right here, like I was saying, it's the identification and attributions. It's all the letters and markings and stuff. So you can see, you have like the Russia Sestroyevsk Arsenal. Then USSR, Izvest Arsenal, and Russian Izvest Arsenal. And I can't say that properly. The Imperial Tula, Peter the Great. You have all these things. And then a lot of the numbers. Like, these would be the parts markings. And Russia, then the Finland Finnish things. There are a lot of different marks, you know, like Circle R for Remington. Marks parts, right there. You know, New England Westinghouse. It has pretty much every single thing. Even lists some numbers, some markings that are found on rifles that have they don't know the meaning of. Let me see if I can find one. Like North, they have the North Korean Star, which so far I don't believe any have been imported yet, but I'm sure in the next 10 to 20 years someone's going to get their hands on a North Korean marked rifle. Not sure, I don't see anything that says unidentified technical control. There's somewhere here they do have. And then they have like the first logo for New England Westinghouse and the second. But anyway, they also, it's a really good book for collectors. You have all kinds of different things, like down to how many screws are supposed to be in each part. To just this different types of handguards, different types of receivers like scallops, less scallop, and no scallop, and then like on the finished barrels from Tikhakovsky and all the other things. Different rifles, even some trainers like the Polish had a single shot 22 that looks like a Mosin. Then they have all different type of bayonets, like experimental 1936 bayonet, as you can see there, a blade bayonet designed by the Russians. Or the Soviets, and different slings, you know, unlike just the cloth, even the finished slings, finished bayonets, covers, muzzle caps, all kinds of different things, and then different bullets, like the D-Patron, I believe it's called, for the finish. I actually did not completely finish, I have a little bit more. I do plan on finishing this book, so I just thought this would be really good to show you guys, and if you are a collector, you must get this book. For if you're for the Mosin-Nagant, they also have different types. You can see here for the 1903, the U.S. Carbine, the M1 Garand. That's the one I want to get because I got a 56 or 55 or 56 Garand. So anyway, I thought this would be a good video. So this is Millsarab Dude. As always, please rate, subscribe, comment, and Millsarab Dude out.